Speaking of best friends, honestly, we've all grown up together, you know. We've held each other's babies when they're born, been at each other's weddings and all that kind of stuff. And so to be back on stage with one another, it feels just really easy, you know. But we may be on the, we've been out for 10 days, which is kind of a long time for us. And like Duncan says, we sort of hit these walls a little bit, we get a bit tired. The thing is, you're going to get the best show ever. I feel like we're getting better. Like every night we are getting
much better.
Especially
much better. Better. Do you want me to try and talk like you? You don't have that kind of jolly feel. You can't talk like me, Joe, because you're not African American.
Oh, no. I can't. Or is it not allowed to?
You're from the land.
Is it not
to? You're from the land of sheep, Phil.
Yes, I am.
How about knitting me a wool blanket, Phil?
As you can see, the band's falling apart right before your eyes.
Hey, we're going to move on to another question here right here in the middle.
Okay, we got it. It's going to be a great show tonight.
One thing I'm sure a lot of us appreciate a lot is so much scripture is right through your songs and heartfelt. Just a question open to any of you guys. For now, what's a passage or a few verses that really you've been held on to personally and inspired you in your walk with Christ?
Phil.
What you got, Phil?
Yeah. What inspired you, Phil?
Well, you got your Bible on you? Okay, well, I like Micah 6:8, which is what is required of a righteous man to do kindness, love justice, and walk humbly with his God, right? I like that one. But I've got a little story attached to that verse. You know, often they'll give us
Sharpies
to write with. Sharpies, not
Sharpies.
Sharpie. Anyway, you know, there's Sharpies. And you know, when you get them when they're fresh, they're nice and pointy, and they're sharp. And then after a while, they get blunt, and they get round. And so at some point there, I guess I was signing Micah 6:8 after my name, and the 6 turned into a 1 because of the, you know, Sharpie. Started getting emails saying, hey, what's going on with this? Why are you signing Micah 1:8 after your name? I'm thinking, Micah 1:8.
Oh,
yeah. So I get my Bible, I look it up, I think, I better find out what this is. Micah 1:8. I will run naked through the fields, howling like a jackal, screeching like a loon. Yeah. Powerful.
The scripture that's really inspired me lately is Micah 1:8.
It's your life first, right, Pete? Yeah, Pete's life first right there.